Hi, in this video I want to demonstrate how to use the new Consistent Block Encrypter in the Sculpt operating system. But before we start, please note that the Consistent Block Encrypter is yet not meant to be used in a productive context. Now, the first thing that I need is a hard disk with at least 2 GB of free space. Then I enable the System Lock Side panel and establish an internet connection. To be able to download the required packages for this demo, I have to enable 2 package sources. The first thing I want to install is the themed window manager. Of course, after I have installed the package, I have to set the routes for the required resources. Then the window manager will be deployed in the runtime. Furthermore, I will need a font server. I can use the font file system package for this. With this setup, I can already start a system shell using the Nux system package. As you can see, I will let this system shell access the root of my file system. The system shell will start in the background in the runtime view. I can switch to the runtime view using the F12 key. In the system shell, I create a new directory for the disk image that will be the backing store of my CBE device. Now I want to narrow access for the CBE tools to the CBE directory. I can use the CBE file system package for this. This package brings a simple change root component that was configured for this use case. Now, in order to create the disk image, I want to use the DD tool. However, unfortunately, the DD tool is not part of the Nux system package. Therefore, I will deploy the CBE shell package instead. The CBE shell will have access only to the CBE directory. Now I can go to the alternative shell and create an empty 2 GB disk image for the CBE. So now this is done. You can see the CBE disk image is about 2 GB in size. Then I can remove the CBE shell again. And now I have to initialize the CBE device in the new disk image. For this I use the CBE init package that I'm now downloading. We will give him access to the CBE file system and deploy the component. It will take a while, and then you can see in the system log that the CBE init component is done. So we can remove it again. Now let's check the new CBE device for consistency. For this, there is the CBE check package that I am downloading right now. Access to the CBE file system again, and here we go. Now the consistency check will take some time because it has to check every single hash in the CBE device. Like with the CBE init component, at the end it will tell me if it was successful in the system log. There we go. So now the CBE check component can be removed again. So let's get ready for the virtual machine here. First, I will need another file system to hold the installation image and the virtual machine configuration. The CBE virtual machine file system is a change root that was exactly configured for this. I will give him access to the used file system, and here we go. Now I want to download Linux for my virtual machine. I can use the download core plus package for this. That will download a simple tiny core. I will give him access to the CBE virtual machine file system, of course. As soon as the component is started, you can see a status window in the back. It shows us how much is downloaded already. This will take some time, as the image is approximately 200 MB in size. This downloader will not only download the installation image, but also a virtual machine configuration and the default disk image. We will remove these two because we don't need them. So you can see now that I am going to the virtual machine directory. There we have the configuration and the VDI, and I have removed them. Then I want to copy some prepared configuration and disk image for the CBE virtual machine. These two files were already downloaded as a dependency of the other CBE packages. So I can copy them directly from my depo into this directory. As you can see, the VMDK file that I just copied references my consistent block encryptor device. Next, I want to start my CBE device driver. The CBE device driver is deployed as a plugin for the VFS server. So I deploy the CBE VFS package. I'll give him access to the CBEFS. And there it is. As the CBEVFS package might use some CPU time, I want to reconfigure it to run on a different core of my CPU. Therefore, I copied the current deploy configuration to the launcher directory. Then I go to the files commands, open the newly created file, and then I remove everything from this file except the CBEVFS start node. Now I have to rename the start node into launcher node. And then I can add my configuration for the affinity of this component. This configuration will cause this component to run on the second core of my CPU. I can save it now. Go back to the components view. Remove the current CBE VFS instance and start it again with the newly created launcher. So, next, for the virtual machine, I also need a shared file system. I can start this with the default launcher. Then I can download the virtual machine monitor. It comes as VirtualBox 5 Nova package in the CBE directory. I will give him access to the virtual machine file system and declare that it will use the CBE VFS as its backing store. And here we go. Let's see. Okay. The virtual machine now starts with the installation image. I would start at the tiny core desktop. And now I will have a look whether it has detected our CBE disk. Yep, there we have it. 1 GB of virtual block device. So, next I want to install the tiny core on this hard disk. This will take a minute. Done. Of course, we have to consider that the performance of the CBE is not yet the best. There will be further improvement regarding this in the near future. So now we can shut down the tiny core and we want to force it to boot next time from the hard disk. So we go to the files controls and then we navigate to the virtual machine directory, enter the machine VBox file. And there we can remove this storage controller for the DVD, for the installation DVD. That's it, we save it. And then we have to restart the virtual machine monitor. Okay, so now in the background we can see that the tiny core already has started to boot from the disk. And now we're running 100% on the consistent block encryptor. Here we go. So, let's give some load on the system. We might want to install a web browser, for instance, by going to the TCE command. Then I will select the Firefox get latest shell script, install it, and now I can run the shell script. So the connection to the server unfortunately timed out. I have to retry. Now it's installing the Firefox on the CBE hard disk. Gonna have to be a little bit patient for this. And that's it. So finally we can start our Firefox. And let's see. Here we go. some random website just to show that it works. Okay, now we might want to demonstrate a little bit the controls of the consistent block encryptor. Therefore, I start again the CBE shell, but this time I will give it access to the CBE VFS, as you can see, because the CBE VFS also provides the advanced control interface of the CBE. Here we have the shell, and then let's have a look at the control interface in the VFS. There are three directories, and in the control directory we have create snapshot, discard snapshot, extend and rekey. So let's create a snapshot of the current state of our virtual machine. And there it is, the snapshot of the device generation 91. And as we can see now, the snapshot has the same size as the CBE device. Oh, wrong name. There you go. Okay, this was pretty fast because creating snapshots is done very efficient in the CBE. Now let's do something more interesting. We want to extend the CBE device. As you can see, the CBE device still has a size of 1 GB. And now I will write the command to extend the virtual block device by 256 MB. Or 65,000 blocks to the extend file in the controls directory. Now the operation is running, and as you can see, I don't have to stop the virtual machine for this. I can view the progress of the extension of the virtual block device. And I can also use the virtual machine during the operation. So it has reached the final size. We can also view the state of the operation through the control extend file. We can see here it has successfully finished. Now, similarly to the extension of the virtual block device, we can extend the pool of sparse blocks that the CBE has. This pool is used whenever the CBE needs to save a node state. So the bigger the pool is, the more old state can be saved in the CBE. This extension was much faster because we added not that many blocks. And we can see again it was successful. Now, the next thing we want to do is to rekey the CBE device. In order to rekey the CBE device, all blocks in the device have to be re-encrypted. So eventually we can remove the old key. I've now started the rekeying process, and I want to demonstrate now that the virtual machine stays active throughout the whole rekeying and that we can use it normally. So I'd like to reboot the tiny core. Okay, let's see. The rekeying is still in progress. For larger CBE devices, the rekeying normally is a long-term operation. Another thing that has to be considered is that during rekeying or the extension of a pool of the CBE device, the CBE device reacts a little bit slower than normally. So I expect the Linux to boot up slower now. So here we are again. The Linux booted from the CBE device that is in the rekeying process, and I could now continue using it. I hope you enjoyed this demo. So thanks for watching.